Welcome to NearImagination.com. Please do subscribe if you didn't yet and ring the bell with subscribe button to get notified as and when I upload my new video. Today I'm telling you why your sewing machine stuck over somewhere like this. You can see it is not moving. Its hand wheel is not moving at all. So for that we should just open these all parts and then clean them. So here I'm teaching you how to open all sewing parts and clean them for damn big problem if your sewing machine is not working at all. So there are two bolts which I'm opening. One more thing to understand is just keep all these parts as you are taking out, and so that you will be able to know that you are taking this first and you will insert that part at the end. Okay, so you will just denote 1, 2, 3 whenever you are taking all these parts out. And you can see if we want to see, here is lots of dust. You can see here, if you see, whenever you are sewing canvas, buckram or any clothes, so this happens, this type of dust stuck with your sewing machine. Then you have to clean your sewing machine after at least 1 month or 2 months. So it is required. One more thing you can see here, this is not working at all. It is not moving. It means it is jam. That after removing that, this sewing machine is moving somewhat. But even now it is somewhat heavy than normal sewing machine. So we have to work on this sewing machine as well as in this shuttle. So see, if we turn it, it is not moving correctly. Here you can see, if I remove this disc out of it, you can see there is lots of rust over here, which you can see on iron metal. There is rust over here. This can come because of some moisture in this monsoon season. Some moisture can come, or maybe some drops of water can go inside this. Just because of that, this rust is happening. Here I'm checking this motor part whether it is working or not. After removing all these parts, it is working all right, and I just remove my rubber out of that. And you can see this is plain napkin. I took this plain napkin and I applied some drop of oils, and after that we just want to remove this rust. You can see, if we remove rust, you can see clearly how dusty my hanky is. Now this rust is transferred to my hanky, or you can say the napkin. You can use any old cotton cloth or napkin. That is your choice. Paper napkin. So just apply some drops. Just pour few drops of oil on this napkin. And then clean your shuttle with help of this. You can see all rust will come out. And this should be clean as metal. Clean this thoroughly. After that, you are going to clean this disc. There is one disc which is out, and there is one disc with sewing machine. You are going to clean that with help of this napkin. You can just fold this napkin and try to reach to all edges of this disc and this shuttle. Insert this disc into this shuttle and then see carefully how we are cleaning. This is another method to clean it clearly. Just pour some oil, and then we are going to circulate this oil into this shuttle so that it will work correctly. Now again we are going to cleaning this excess of oil. If there is any excess oil, this will come out on this paper napkin, and any dust, any remaining dust will come out. So this is the reason why your sewing machine is working very heavy and it's not working at all. It's jammed on one place. So you should clean everything. This is required every 2 months. So just insert this disc. Now you can see it is working freely. So there is no hurdles in circulating it. Now it is neat and clean. So here it is required to insert pour some oil. Like so. Now with help of a brush you can clean every small part of this sewing machine. It is very important to clean with help of this brush. You can use any brush, there is no such rule for that. You can use any painting brush, whatever you are having at your home. And on the bottom side as well, you can see there are some dust, there are some cotton like dust. So you just turn it wherever your machinery is moving. If wherever there are joints which are moving, you should oil them. After oiling, you will be able to find any dust if there is any. So it is required on the bottom side of this sewing machine. With help of this, you will be able to maintain your sewing machine for longer time and your sewing machine will work like new sewing machine. Now, after inserting these oil, you will take a cloth or any piece of paper and then clean this thoroughly. This oiling part is also important. Now you can see this is dust which we got from these joints. So this come out of these joints. That is why we are cleaning this. Because of this, these joints are stucking with each other. That is why they are not working freely. Now it is time to apply these all parts again. And after oiling, you will see whether it is working correctly or not. Yes, it is working. And then we will apply all parts. As we took them out, you should apply them correctly. If you apply them wrongly, then your machine will not work correctly. So it is required to remember which part you took first, that part. Then you will insert that part at the end. And there is one bolt you are going to fix it with help of this instrument, screwdriver. Fix it correctly and tightly. Now we are going to insert this inside this place. Just remember to match this disc. It means one disc will come toward one side and another disc will come toward another side. Okay, and then we are going to match these two holes of this shuttle. You can see here are two holes. If you have another machine, then even then you can just clean your machine. For example, if you have half shuttle, full shuttle, you will clean that machine as per your machine part. But one thing here to remember is whatever you took out, you should just remember which you took out first and on at the end. So this, there is one hole, you should match this hole. So I'm just tightening it. After lining the hole of this, we are tightening it and we are tightening this bolt into this. Now, one more thing to understand is you should see whether your needle is inserting correctly or not. If this is tucking over here only, if it is not going inside, you can see it is going inside. If it is not going inside, then it means your disc are not aligned correctly. Then you should open it again and then align your disc correctly, because that must be, you know, attracting or sticking with those discs. So your needle should go freely. Now we are tightening these screws. Like so. Now if you see, it is working freely and there is no voice as such. And this is so smooth. After cleaning this sewing machine, it is working so smooth. Over here, I am going to attach this belt, motor belt, with the motor. Here you can see, here is the motor belt. Firstly, you should insert this belt in this motor. There is one bobbin like thing. You will insert this belt on the on the motor, and then you will insert on the wheel of the sewing machine like we are inserting. You can see it is inserted over here. Now we are going to insert this belt on this wheel. If in your case, if the belt is not correct, it means if the belt is not fine, if there is any cut in the belt, even then this problem can occur. As in my case, there is a small cut in my belt, so I am just using that belt to what extent it will work. After that, I will change this belt. After this, we will check whether it is working correctly or not. Yes, it is working correctly and so smooth. We are able to correct it. We are able to fix the problem of machine jam. Now we are going to insert this oil. It means oiling is really very important after each week. It means in a week, you have to oil your machine in all holes, whatever your machine is having. It must be written over here. Oil is written on over here on these holes, and you are going to insert them. Firstly, you insert in the part which is going up and down, and all this part which I shown. Once in a week, you should oil your machine. And when you are starting this again, it is working so smooth. Even after inserting this cloth, it is working smoothly, and I am able to repair my sewing machine at my home. With me, you are able to learn how to repair your sewing machine at home. Keep watching neimagination.com. Please do subscribe, and there is neimagination. If you click over here, you will get this bell icon. So click on this bell icon so that you will get notified as and when I upload my new video. There is video column. Here you will find all my videos under playlists. You will find all my playlists, whether in English or Hindi. Thank you.